Hi everyone and welcome back to Creative PowerPoint. Today, I will show you how to make a dynamic product presentation that will wow your audience. Here's an example. Let's see how we did that. First, let's review the overall structure of the deck. It's composed of 11 slides, one slide for every major step of the animation. For all the slides, the morph transition is selected. When it does a transition between two slides, morph transforms every object individually from one slide into the next one. Let's see how we animated the 3D phone. As a reminder, you can insert 3D models into a PowerPoint presentation. Microsoft provides some free online stock, but if you want more, you can also find many 3D models for free or for a fee on the internet. If you prefer, you can also make your own models in a tool like Blender. Let's add our phone on slide 1. Go to the Insert tab and click on 3D model. In my case, I downloaded my model from a stock website, so I'll select this device, choose my file, and click on Insert. Now, just rotate the 3D model as you wish. Let's play the transition once again to make sure it works as expected. Now, let's see how we made the scrollings. On the left pane, you can see the actual visible area of slide 8, and you can see that only the skater is visible. However, on the main pane, you can see that this slide contains hidden content. I've duplicated the content of slide 7, hidden at the top, and I've also duplicated the content of slide 9, hidden at the bottom. And that's the trick. I want the content of slide 7 to scroll up when I display slide 8. That's why I copied the content of slide 7 at the top of slide 8. And I also want the content of slide 9 to pull from the bottom when I move from slide 8 to slide 9. That's why I preposition that content at the bottom of slide 8. And the morph transition does the magic. To add some flair, I made sure the objects move at different speeds. This creates a parallax effect and an impression of depth. I also used a few other tricks to enhance the result. For example, I played with transparent text, semi-transparent overlays, blur effects. We won't show everything in detail, but I think you get the idea. The possibilities are endless, and I encourage you to play around with the morph transition and see what works for you. Hello? Sorry, wrong number. If you like this video and would like to be notified about the next one, don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell. Leave me comments, share this video to your colleagues and friends, and I'll see you next week for more PowerPoint creative tricks.